Alright, click the links for the alternative platforms to support the channel, either anonymously or not anonymously, or to join the Discord, which, to be fair, is absolute cancer, but it is a good way to stay in touch. Okay, so this is Scientific America, which is no, it used to be a pop culture magazine, but that, it used to be well written. Now it's no longer a scientific, it's not no longer a scientific publication. It's propaganda. It's Pravda. So 3 out of the 4 writers have areas of research or their PhDs in education, not in science. And the fourth one has a degree in ecology or area of study of ecology. So you've got 1 scientist and 3 degrees in education nowadays, or at least in the past 20 or 30 years, are nothing better than working at the Ministry of Education in Orwell's book, which actually I'm rereading right now, and it's an excellent, excellent read. So this doesn't belong in a scientific publication, even one that's pop science, which this is. It used to be pop science, but it was good pop science. And now it's not even that, it's just this weird 1984 newspeak. Alright, the Jedi and Western storytelling. The need to destroy Western storytelling and the West in general, and they are very successfully doing it, and we're pretty far along. Some of these deeper concepts I see in pop culture deal with this one here, that people are not equal. You can check the archive link and read the whole article if you want. It's a quick read. The deeper one is that people are not equal, which the woke kids are terrified to examine. They are the college kids who want to censor from behind a safe space. In other words, there are a lot of, I'll say, low vibrational people in America, as you saw from that ASU video of those 2 girls who were unable to articulate their thoughts. They were literally too stupid to transcend emotion into logic. And also because they never had to before. They never had to defend their ideas. So number one is different things are different. And number two is that different tribes, sexes, how many sexes are there? Identities are allowed to have their own spaces with the right to exclude others. This is a concept that enrages them, which is why they keep pushing this inclusive language and concept, which, oddly enough, while being exclusive of people that they disagree with. Why would women go into battle? None of this makes sense. Really, it boils down to they want the right to keep you out of their group, but that you may not maintain your right to exclude them, which is another term for slavery. I keep saying use their terms against them. You are what you feel. If you feel like a gay, trans, marginalized, and oppressed POC, then you are. Now, if once women can be men, then the adults have left the room and the rules are off the table. Once you accept that, as Orwell says, 2 + 2 = 4, if you can start from there, then anything goes. But once you accept that men are women, then anything goes, yes, but also sort of in the opposite direction of illogic, and where causation doesn't matter. Myself, I'm finally able to live my truth as a trans, lesbian, marginalized, oppressed, disenfranchised Jewish woman of color. If you doubt my lived experience, then you're literally taking part in my oppression, and that makes you racist. We are in a post-logic world. They control the narrative. They set the rules, mostly, but you can also use their rules to out-crazy the crazy. Elizabeth Warren got a job because she claimed to be an American Indian. So she took that job away from a real American Indian as a professor. In case you're not aware, she is not an American Indian. My point is, as anyone could tell who just looked at her, my point is, you may as well have some fun while the ship heads for the rocks. And it definitely is. Really, it has the left firmly invested in the unscientific notion that different people or entities or things are equal. It doesn't matter where in the world you are. They believe that all humans have a very low variance in their abilities, that as groups, they're all close to the same. They offer no science to support this. It has become a matter of faith to them. It turns out that when you take religion away, nature abhors a vacuum, so they fill it with a new belief system, even if it's this modern Bolshevik, neo-Bolshevism. So identical twins aren't even equal. So the concept is nonsense on the face of it, but they lose their minds if you dare question the narrative. Different humans have different strengths and weaknesses. It's like saying that men are different from women. If you say that, you're basically a monster. That is a whole different can of worms. And while the people on Twitter seem to, they say that, I don't know, trans men are women or something like that, and then they clap their hands in between. And then simple people who have some familiarity with the English language and logic say, if something is equal to something else, then you don't have to include a modifier before it. You don't say trans. You just don't. You don't need to. You can just say women are women. You wouldn't say trans women are women because the modifier just proves the logical fault in your statement, because that's how the language works. You're saying 2 + 2 = 4 and 2 + 2 = 5. Well, you have a situation there. Movies may just not be for us anymore post these 2020 riots. Seriously, like, we might have to make our own movies. It's better to watch a low-budget, sub-million-dollar film shot, like, on a rented summer camp than the standard woke abortions that's out there now. Mainstream movies are going to be unwatchable until after the Civil War, and then each side can make what they choose. Anyway, so Luke Skywalker and the Jedi, this group of Kvetchin Yenta busybodies, are basically just looking for attention. Like I said, you've got 3 degrees in education and 1 degree in ecology, so, like, why are the 3 education people even writing articles in a Scientific America publication? They hate the European people. Believe me, if you told me I would be talking like I'm speaking now 5 years ago, I just would not have understood where you're coming from. Aren't we all Americans trying to get along? No. All that Pollyanna crap is dead and buried. Those days are long gone. I don't see that America, that old America, people lament the passage of the 90s, going back to the 90s and realizing, yeah, that was probably a pretty good period of time. That old America is gone forever. It's never coming back. Multiculturalism just showed people how much different tribes hate each other. So even to say that is probably a wrong thing for you, too. Nothing these builders of straw men say matters. It's all an opinion that they don't even believe. George Lucas wrote a story from his perspective. Russians, African, French, Irish, all write from their perspective. Lucas wrote better than most people. People enjoyed his simple story told well. He had very good actors for the roles. They had amazing chemistry. It's like when we talk about lightning in a bottle, you're talking about the 3 or 4 or 5 main actors in Star Wars and the chemistry together. Like, you just don't get that often. That's why good movies are rare. He had great props. The props were just the detail that went into them. The sets were amazing. It's a simple concept. Obviously, it's easier said than done, which is why it's so rare, and everyone tries to reach that lightning in the bottle. So this article should have been a parody, and I'm almost expecting someone to say, oh, you fell for it. Oh, thank God. Thank God it was a parody and I fell for it, but I don't think so. It's 4 people who started off with a false premise. JEDI, as an acronym, Justice, Equity, Diversity, and Inclusion, are good things. That's their premise, but they never explain why they feel that way. Right off the bat, I can tell you that equity, diversity, and inclusion are evil things. And they make the scientific publication, they make no attempt to prove any of this scientifically. It's just a feelings-based opinion piece. Again, which, why isn't it a scientific publication? Because it's no longer a scientific publication. That ship has sailed. Equity, diversity, and inclusion are bad things. They lead to the decay of society. They are globalist ideals. Start with this. Where have these concepts worked, and why do the authors think that they're good things? They start with a conclusion, and then they get upset when the world doesn't fit their flawed conclusion. They're not doing science, not anything close to it. They're obviously just doing propaganda. I don't mean that because we're on opposing sides of the political spectrum, which I guess we are. I mean, from a scientific point of view, this doesn't belong in a scientific journal of any sort, not even pop culture. This is a BuzzFeed ADL type of opinion, propaganda, brainwashing piece. A good thing. That's why I mentioned inclusion and the concept of discrete entities, which means boundaries. There is a point where one thing ends and one new thing begins, which the left hates. There is a UK turf war, or row, going on regarding a bunch of women who want the right to form groups as women and exclude men. The trans community is outraged, incandescent with rage. But when people ask them if biological men or women have the right to form groups and exclude people of the opposite sex, they never make an answer, because the answer is no. Which is why when people start with the conclusion that inclusion, is to be a good thing, it's not. It's brainwashing. Discrete tribes have the right to exclude whom they wish for whatever reason they wish, because they have autonomy over their bodies and their minds. What I just said to the left amounts to an invasion of Poland. They do not want discrete tribes with borders. They flat out do not believe that discrete entities exist, that they have the right to exclude those with whom they wish to exclude, because globalists are parasites. They can only survive when attached to a host. They also know that they don't have, if they don't have access to a group, then they can't censor that group. And that group will think and think, And they'll talk about how these censorious globalists have interests adverse to theirs. It's why they lose their minds when you have some private political or ideological group that excludes these parasites. All of a sudden, they are very concerned with diversity and inclusion for your group, but not for their group. You have bodily autonomy. We also have group autonomy, the right to collect some, gather some to our bosom, and exclude others, which in current year is a double plus ungood wrongthink. It's nationalism versus pseudo-globalism. It's shifting away from multiculturalism into a culture of those you choose to associate yourself with, forming a culture of your tribe, building in-group preference, and excluding others so you can focus on your tribe and advancing and protecting its interests. It's building a discrete group and saying that this is us and you are not us. Even in something as simple as Comicsgate, which is a YouTube group for roughly for comics, it's saying that SJWs and far-left commies are not welcome here because they will destroy us. It's a group that is not inclusive to SJWs because they'll just destroy it by creating rules of censorship. More and more things will need representation or need to be off-limits so as not to offend those groups that force their way in. Diversity, inclusion, censorship, and representation is what we wanted to escape. You already have that in Marvel, DC, and Hollywood. It's cringy and lame. I want to use another word, but lame will have to suffice. Mainstream comics in Hollywood are discrete entities with borders. Europeans, Christians, nationalists are not welcome in those spaces. There's a thing online about this guy applied for a job at DuckDuckGo in tech, and he has one application as himself, and he didn't make it to the second round, and he had another application as a lesbian walk with spelling errors, and he made it to the second round, and it's floating around. You can search that. It's on Gab. It's hysterical. You're not welcome in their spaces. They won't hire you, and they don't even want you as customers. Not really. So you have the moral high ground if you're concerned about that. In reality, you can treat the vermin the way that they treat you. Anyway, I don't know. Is this too heavy for YouTube? Maybe. Someone just invited me to a Discord, said, if you want to get away from politics for a little while, this is a nice, relaxing Discord. Oh, you. Anyway, I'll see you guys all next episode.